Welcome back to Spellup Tutorial Services. Today we're going to continue our talk on vectors. We're going to begin with the question above. Two forces, F1 and F2, of magnitudes 15 and 25 pounds respectively, act on an airplane, and we see that depicted here in the drawing. Force 1, 15 pounds magnitude, force 2, 25 pounds magnitude. The direction of F1 is north 40 degrees east, and the direction of force 2 is north 70 degrees east. Both of those directions are given in bearings. So from north, vector 1 moved 40 degrees east, and for vector 2, from north, moving in an eastward direction, 70 degrees. We need to find the magnitude and the direction of the resultant force. So let's begin by converting force 1 into its I and J components. We know that the formula for that would be, let me switch to red to keep everything uniform. We know that force 1, the formula is the magnitude of force 1 cosine theta I plus the magnitude of force 1 again sine theta J. All right, you notice here that we need to figure out what theta is for force 1. Well, we know that it has a 40 degrees from north, and we're in quadrant 1. We know that each quadrant has a measure of 90 degrees. So this angle here has to be 50 degrees because 50 plus 40 is 90. So we know theta is 90. All right, the magnitude, that's also given as 15 pounds. So we just list 15 cosine, I'm sorry, I'm putting 20, but actually it's 50, cosine 50i plus the magnitude again times sine 50j. Right, using your calculator to evaluate 15 times cosine 50, and that evaluates to 9.6418i, and you evaluate 15 times the sine of 50, and that evaluates to 4907j. Alright, so we have our I and J components for force 1. Now let's go to force 2. For force 2, we know that it had a bearing of 70 degrees north 70 degrees east. So we know this angle here, theta, has to be 20 degrees because 70 plus 20 is 90. So here I'm going to just skip a little bit and go straight to the substituting in the values. We know that the magnitude of F2 is 25. Cosine, we just said the angle was 20 degrees. I plus, again, 25 sine 20j. All right, when we evaluate, we know the I component comes out or evaluates to 23.4923i, and the J component evaluates to 8.5505j. So now I have my force 1 and force 2 both in their I and J components. Now we're going to add those two vectors together to get the resultant force. Let me go ahead and switch to green. We know from previous videos that to add two forces together, you add the appropriate components. So here we're going to add the two I components together, and the two I components are going to add up to 33.1341i, and then we add our J components, and our J components add up to 20.0412j. Now that I have those two components, I can now figure out what the magnitude of this vector is. So the magnitude of F sub R would be the square root of the I component squared plus the J component squared. So that's going to be 33.1341. Excuse me, let me slow down a little bit so I can get my writing device to work properly. 13.41, and I'm going to square that, plus going to square my J component, 20.0412. And the result for that is going to be 7236. So here I have found the magnitude of the resultant force. Now I need to find the direction. And to find the direction, I'm going to do a sketch here so that we can better see how we come to that result. All right, so I've got this force, which I'm calling FR, or F sub R, so it's my resultant force. The I component is 33.1341, and then I know that was the horizontal component. Now the vertical component, the J component, I know that that there is 20.0412, and I know the angle created in here is theta. So I know that if I take the tangent, 20.0412 divided by 33.1341. If I take the arctangent of this particular equation here, I know that theta comes out to be 58.8323. So that's what theta is here. And if I wanted to figure out what my bearing is, I have to go from north. So to figure out what that is, I'm going to take 90 minus theta, and that's going to give me 31.1677 degrees east. 77 degrees. All right, so that sums it up for this video by Spell Tutorial Services. Please friend us on Facebook, and also stay tuned to our YouTube page. Both pages found under the name Spell Tutorial Services.